Hello, Darren Ragsdale with Jasper Engines. Today, I want to talk to you a little bit about that wonderful check engine light that comes on. And today, specifically, I'm going to talk about that 04 to 2010 F-150 with that 5.4 Ford in it. You know, the first thing that when I see those check engine lights, I always think, oh my gosh, how much money am I going to spend? The other thing is, can I do without my vehicle? How much time is it going to take to repair this? So, first thing I would recommend, first of all, don't get excited. First thing we need to see is what those codes are and really what the computer is trying to tell us. We got to read that code. So the first thing I would do is if you have a buddy that has a code reader, maybe he can read those codes for you, see exactly what they are. The other thing that you can do, you can go down to your repair facility, see if they can help you out. Usually I would figure about an hour's worth of diagnostic time if you're paying somebody to do that. The other thing, if you don't have an installer, you can visit our website, jasperengines.com. We have an icon on there that has a find installer. Click on that, enter your information, and you will be able to find an installer close to you. Some of the common codes that I'm going to talk to you today about is the P0011 and the P0012. That is the driver bank of this 5.4 engine. The other thing, or on the other side, on the driver's side, you have the P0021 and the P0022. Those codes are identical. It's just telling you exactly what side it's on. What does this mean? It means that for whatever reason, your PCM is detecting that your camshafts are out of position. They could be advanced too far, or they could be retarded. Either one, we've got an issue. Now, one thing that you can do, some short list of possibilities that it could be, if you really take a look at it, could be a defective camshaft sensor. Could be a defective wiring, maybe a short or open wire somewhere. Even low engine oil pressure can cause this. Restricted oil flow to the VCT valve body. The most common thing on this has been that VCT solenoid. That has been very common. And there are other things that can cause it, but those are some of the things that it could be. If you're do-it-yourselfer, one thing I would recommend doing, if you haven't changed your oil in a while, go ahead and change that oil and filter. You never know, that just may fix it. The other thing that you can do, if it's a cam sensor, maybe you can switch it from side to side. Or if it's that VCT solenoid, go ahead and swap those around. There's a lot of instructional videos out there on the web that you can look at that will help you exactly how to do that. I hope it's something simple. But if it turns out to be something a little major, you can go to our website, jasperengines.com. On there, you will be able to find pricing. You can find that installer. You find out all of our warranty information. The other nice thing about this is if you click on our videos, there is a great update video on the oil pump for this 5.4 engine that will go through and show you exactly what goes on internally with that oil pump. It's very cool. Check it out. Again, if you have any questions, visit our website, jasperengines.com. Thank you and have a great day.